is it? How many watts is it pulling?
Like 110.
Oh, shoot. Dude, these guys are here already.
What's up, everybody? How you doing?
I guess they're here to see your truck, I think.
Oh, yeah. Well, I think they're here for Sierra, actually.
She's excited.
Oh, boy. I know. She's so happy.
So that's actually the star of my channel. I'm just here to make sure she's got treats and, you know, she's comfy and all that stuff. So he takes her truck camping.
Yeah, actually. But she tells me what to do, so.
But, yeah, Brian and I met a couple years ago. He's been full-timing for, like, 6 years. Mm-hmm. And it's always fun to meet up. Always different spots and different places. So today, we're just going to check out your truck and have you show us through. You know the deal. But you did a really cool rear bumper swing out thing.
Yeah, I did a bunch of upgrades.
Lots of other stuff.
Yeah, so. I did like, I think it was a total of 9 upgrades just about a month ago. Cool. And every day I'm out here.
Yeah.
So even in the wintertime, I do it in a four-season tent with a wood stove, for those that don't know. Right now, my current setup's pretty big. It's got a wood stove in it, but it kind of takes all day to move. My new setup will be to where I can backpack with it. And so I'll have a wood stove on a toboggan sled with a tent behind me that I'm pulling, a lightweight tent, and it's gonna be insane. So this winter, the winter camping adventure is gonna be sick.
But yeah, well, cool. Let's check out some more details, right?
Yeah, let's start in the front.
And all then, right, cool. Let's get this little guy off of here.
Starting out, the first thing that I did was I wanted to improve the ride of the Tacoma, because the factory ride's great, but I have the Old Man Emu lift kit from ARB. It's a really great lift kit, but the problem is it's really stiff, which actually serves you well in overlanding, because you're carrying so much gear, your vehicle is typically gonna have a lot of weight in it. So the ride was really stiff, and what I wanted to do is I wanted to test out some new upper control arms and see if that would improve the ride at all. So what I got was I invested in the JBA Off-Road upper control arm for the Toyota Tacoma. This is the one that if you have a lift, you get this one, and it helps give another inch travel in the upper control arm. So when you're on trails, it doesn't have near the same bounciness and, you know, reaction to rocks in the road that you normally have. You kind of just roll over them now. And then another thing I did was I wanted to have it to where I could easily air down my tires and air them back up. So I usually go down to about 20 PSI. That makes it to where the ride's really comfortable. But then I have to air it back up. And so using this right here, what I got was a dual air compressor from ARB. That right there will run the cords that I'll like the air pressure up hose that I'll do to my vehicles. I can go from like 20 PSI to about 34 PSI. In 40 seconds for each tire, which is pretty fast. At the snorkel over here, a lot of people mistakenly think the snorkel is for water crossings, and while it helps with that, it's actually just better for better air quality on the Tacoma. That's the main benefit of this one, because unfortunately the Tacoma's air intake is right here on the standard factory, at least on the 2005, which is one of the worst places in my opinion to have it, because you're sucking up dust from trails all the time, especially if you're following people. So moving the air intake to up here, it's actually turns it into somewhat of a cold air intake, so it increases the performance of your engine, and it's just better for your air filters. And
it looks super overlandy.
I know it does. It's a little bit overkill in my opinion, but it's kind of cool too.
I like it.
One thing I really wanted to get was I wanted to upgrade the side steps here, because the factory side steps from the Tacoma are just basically plastic, and they don't serve any purpose. So they look like sliders, but they aren't. And so I got with a company out of California called Brute Force Fab and got these rock sliders molded onto my frame so that I can support the weight of my truck. And I can basically use rocks, I can slide over them on obstacles and not have to worry about damaging the undercarriage of my truck with that on the sides.
So yeah, these things look beefy, man.
Yeah, they really are.
It's nice to have them welded up in there.
Yeah, and if you see right there, I mean, there's like 4 weld spots, and they're real solid welds. And that was done by Tomkin Machine out of Granite, Colorado. They did all the welding. What's nice is they're angled in, so when I'm standing up here, I don't ever have to worry about slipping off, which that's actually kind of a big thing in the wintertime when I'm winter camping. I'll get up here because I'll store wood on the top of my truck, on the roof rack and stuff like that, transporting it. And I've slipped off before. Dude, when you slip off in the wintertime and you go down and you're falling down like this and your shins just scrape the whole way and you go down and like, you just say as many cuss words as you know.
Brian's main upgrade to his rig was his brute force fab swing out rear bumper tire carrier, really awesome rock guard protection dealy bob. So he had so much to say about it, and there's so much to show, I decided to make a separate video just on the rear swing out. Brian's also made some little changes to his camper slide out, so let's check that out.
Yeah. Another thing I'm testing out, which I'm actually gonna go get the materials today to make it. I only made a prototype of it, but what it is up here it's normally covered, and I took off the roof of the slide out, you know, and so I'll normally cover this up during the daytime, but at night or at dusk or in the morning when it's cold, it's real nice to have that passive solar.
Mm-hmm.
So I've been testing out this piece of plexiglass here.
Oh, wow.
So if you come in, I want to show you.
And for those who don't know, too, like, this is your custom slide-out extension.
Yeah,
you built
It looks like shit right now, but that's only because I just haven't done much to it. I took off all the siding. I was going to put on, you know, cedar and all that stuff, and I've just been, like, lazy. Because I'm like, yeah, it still works. I'm just camping and going.
Still looks pretty good in videos from a few feet away.
If you get up close, it looks pretty janky. But I would like to buy the stuff and just finish it out because I'm going to get into the new camper in the spring. But what I wanted to do was create to where basically in here, you've got it to where this swivels up because it was fixed. And so you had, it was like just fixed straight across and it wasn't very comfortable. So this swivels up and connects right underneath there, and then you've got sunlight coming in.
Yeah, that's pretty, you know? That's pretty awesome those cold mornings.
Yeah, and so you can sit in here and it warms up super quick. And so this morning I pulled that off as soon as the sun came out, and it was like, boom, warmed up in here real nice.
That's cool.
Yeah, and then also it's real nice for watching stars. When I was in Moab earlier this spring, I watched the meteor shower in April through this.
Cool.
And it's all jacked up right now because, like I said, this is just a prototype to test it out to see if it'll work. But what I'm going to do is put canvas over the sides here so that it'll breathe. So that way you have bug protection on both sides here where the openings are, where it swivels up. And then do like a Velcro connector across the top. That way it easy connects and it disconnects and you're done.
I really like that.
Yeah.
It's a window.
Yeah, basically that's what it is. And then you can cover it up with anything. What I would do on the inside here is I would probably do either a shade on the outside that comes down from the top and goes all the way down there, and it's like a tarp protector, or from the inside. But I'd probably do it on the outside though, because if you had it on the inside, it'd be like an oven.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, you want to protect it from the outside. But it'd be so easy for up top here on the outside just to put a little shade protector that comes down, you know.
Yeah.
So you just pull it down like that and it's covered.
Dude, that's cool.
See, I love thinking about stuff like that. And that's why I still want to build my own topper.
Yeah.
Because I have an idea for my own topper, which I've shared with you, which I think would be a really spacious idea for
super
a Tacoma.
Cool.
So we'll see. But things in here are good. I mean, like Tacoma itself, everything's doing fine with winter camping. I switched out my sleeping bag to the negative 20 degree bag. And then everything's going good, man. I mean, this slide-out extension, I'm surprised. I built this as a freaking prototype, and it's still rocking.
You built it right. I mean, it's...
Yeah. And
it looks awesome. The framing, everything, it looks like...
You see how hard I hit this thing. Like, I jam in this truck, so...
Oh, yeah. No, we're flying. I mean, we're hauling. Even to this spot, we got here at night, about 55 or something.
Yeah, we're always cruising. But it's fun. It's like we can jam anywhere. We can leave town at night and we're like, we'll get to camp, no problem. There's still plenty of time to set up.
Yeah, we were at the getting some pizza at this brewery and came here at night. And yeah, it's fun to have just such comfy setups like this. You can set them up so quick.
Well, and then the, you know, my mission has always been to be as mobile as I can.
Yeah.
You know, and so, the other addition that I did was I got a better fridge. So Dometic sent me that CFX 3, the 45 size, and it's really good. I like this new series. So the CFX was the old, series they had, and now this is the CFX 3, which has a better compressor, it's quieter, and I think it's faster as far as cooldown is concerned. I plugged that thing in and like in 5 minutes it was down to temp.
Wow.
Which I was like, whoa. So I've been real impressed with it. It doesn't have much of an energy draw at all. And it's going good.
Those right.
Sierra, over here, girl. Sierra,
that's a little far away,
Sierra,
girl.
Over here, come on. She's like, but I smell something up here, Dad. It smells like fun. No, girl. So yeah, the next upgrades that I'm doing,
that's
I'll
funny,
probably
Sierra.
Oh, she out there running.
She's coming back, yeah.
the truck here, when I didn't have the upper control arms, it was so rocky and so stiff on the roads that the bumper actually rubbed a little bit, so I'm getting this taken off and sandblasted and then repowder coated. And then when that happens, I'll put on the winch.
Nice.
Because there's no reason to take it off, do this, or take it off just for the winch, and then I got to wait for the guy to
sandblast it. So.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, so that's about it. But it was great upgrades. I'm really pleased with what's going on. And then I got the South Dakota tags because being a nomad, you know, you get the South Dakota tags. You can get them without having without being in a physical address. And so just look it up online. Actually, I'm going to do a blog post about it on my website. So go to offgridbackcountryadventures.com if you want to see it. I'll have it up in a couple days. But it's great. I can get tags sent anywhere in the country now or anywhere in the world to me, really. And they're legit South Dakota tags. So cool. I'm real pleased with that, how everything's turned out. It's just been great. And like, this makes the functionality so much fun to like stand here and be like, oh, this is like my kitchen area and all that stuff. And then just hop on into my living room / bedroom / study / man cave / media room.
Heck yeah, man.
So it's all good.
Well, Brian, it's been amazing seeing some of your spots. Thanks so much for showing me around Colorado. It's been a little bit chilly,
yeah,
but I'm glad you recommended the heated blanket, which has been a game changer.
The $20 game changer, it's what you need.
But yeah, man, always good times, and to see you dialing it in. I always learn something from your setups.
Oh, thanks, man. Yeah. I appreciate that. It's been fun checking out your Jeep, and excited to see how everything's going to end up with that.
Yeah. So yeah, make sure you're following and subscribe to Brian's channel, Off-Grid Backcountry Adventures. And what you got next in the works? Winter's coming up.
Yeah, winter's coming up. So that new tent, like I was talking about with the sled, you know, going to Baga, going backcountry in that. And then I think in the meantime, once the truck gets done, maybe go to like an Arizona, New Mexico nomadic tour for like 6 weeks.
Cool.
Then after that, come back here and start winter camping.
Nice.
Yeah, so we'll see.
The winter camping, man. Yeah, I got to get out, and you guys hold me to that. I got to get out with Brian and get that wood stove going.
Dude, it's so
and
nice.
See what it's all about.
Baking
yeah.
cookies over the stove and stuff while it's raging outside.
It's crazy.
It's the best.
Yeah. But drop a comment. Let us know what you think of Brian's upgrades. And, of course, if you enjoyed the video, be sure to turn that big old thumb blue. And, yeah, we're all down to mob. I think the only question is, are you down to mob?
You.